We want to go through this quick video to talk specifically about the B-side supply system that we're running. Anytime we have a moisture-sensitive coating, such as an isocyanate catalyst or hardener, it's really important that we take care of the B-side differently than all the other sides. So one of the first things that we like to do on the B-side is we like to run a bottom outlet kit. Okay, so the bottom outlet kit ensures that every time we refill catalyst that we don't get air bubbles into the system with the pressure tank. The other reason we also like to use a pressure tank over a pump such as what you see on the far left here is because this is a sealed and closed container. It's really important that if we have air that's feeding the system that it's extremely dry and the humidity is even pulled out of it, which we see typically in a three-stage air filter. But what we typically hear recommended from coating companies is that we actually utilize nitrogen to feed this system. So our air that's coming into the system is typically nitrogen. We wouldn't then use the material to feed out to this. So right now we have a three-stage clean, dry air filtration around the side of our spray booth that's feeding this. So we're okay with this system. But the final piece that I want to talk about is the hose that we use. So we always recommend that you use some sort of moisture lock hose. If you're using a nylon hose or any of our black fluid all hose that we have, there's actually an opportunity for moisture to absorb through those hoses and get into the catalyst line. So instead we have here a PTFE line, and then there's also moisture lock hoses. A lot of common ones that we see out in the field are green hoses. They also are black. But again, it's very important on this side that the B material is essentially just seeing that catalyst. The final point I want to make about the B side is at some point in time, the pump's going to need to be rebuilt and cleaned out. Or if it's not being used so often, one of the most common things that we see people doing is they want to flush out the system. Well, any solvent that we use has some percent of water within that solvent. And when solvent comes in contact with isocyanate catalyst or any other moisture sensitive catalyst, the material can end up hardening up. So if we ever need to clean this out, we always recommend that you do flush out the system, but after you flush it out, you actually take apart our dispense pump in order to clean everything out so you don't have any excess residue in the line. Our biggest recommendation that we have is to never flush this line out with catalyst if your process can handle that. And essentially what we do is we've got everything that we need then to ensure that we have a well-working unit day in and day out. The final kind of piece that ties all this in is we have an oil reservoir at the top of this B pump. What that oil does is it's actually an iso oil that is compatible with any of the catalysts that we have. And this essentially creates a final barrier from the air to get into the system itself. So all of these things are in place. So again, we have PTFE hoses in line. We have proper iso oil that also comes with the systems. We have PTFE hoses feeding through the unit. We have bottom outlet kits. And then we have a nitrogen blanket or a three-stage filter with desiccant air through this to ensure that we don't get any moisture on here. This is probably the most vital area that we want to make sure that we have the right components and the right equipment set up on this so we don't have any chance for the catalyst to absorb moisture, which can end up creating hardened parts of your line and get the equipment to function improperly.